Okay, so this is a different kind of video. This video contains reviews of four movies. Originally, they were their own individual videos, but since I wanted to cover up all these films quickly, I put it all in one video. So this might be a little common in this channel from now on. So yeah, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. You can watch Madari on Z5 and YouTube as of yet. So I urge you to watch this film as it's necessary, especially in today's time and culture. So Nirmal, a common man, kidnaps the son of the home minister due to government's irresponsibility and teaches them a lesson. So the basic plot isn't anything new or different. But what it does with a somewhat generic plot is what makes this film fantastic. Now Nirmal kidnaps Rohan and he is confident, cocky, and it makes sense because he is the son of the home minister, which makes him feel above and superior than the commoner that is Nirmal. But as this film progresses, Rohan is grounded and comes out of his comfort zone. He sees the lives of the other commoners and gets a perspective on the lives of the normal people and their struggles and hardships they go through. Now this film has a very heartwarming theme which still rings in my head and it's very emotional. Now as the film goes forward, we understand why Nirmal does what he does through the use of flashbacks. Nirmal had a son and we see their love through songs and dialogues. We see their lives and their bonds, which makes the death of his son really hard hitting as he is crushed to death by the falling of a dysfunctional bridge. Nirmal is heartbroken and Irfan's scene where he cries in the hospital really pulled your heartstrings. He even plans on attempting suicide but changes his mind as he decides to teach the people a lesson and give them the perspective of a common man. Irfan Khan is perfect for this role and he makes you believe that he is a heartbroken father, and his scene in the train was beautiful. Jimmy Shergill is also in the film and he's phenomenal too. Give him more work, people. He's amazing. Now what makes Nirmal engaging is that he has a problem with the system, but the reason he's interesting as a character is because of his will to act on it, somewhat like Thanos. Since he's actually doing something about it, it manages to keep your interest. It even shows how quick people change sides and their empty sympathy, which is very real in today's world. Now Nirmal's character is the medium through which the corruption of the Indian government is exposed, which is tied to his son's death. The people see the truth, the ugly truth of this government. And I love that Nirmal and Rohan form a bond over the course of the movie. Otherwise, this film would have been boring. It heavily reminded me of Terminator 2 with Arnold and John Connor. Rohan helps Irfan move on from his son's demise, and that was beautiful. So yeah, Madari is a beautiful film that talks about corruption and parent-child disconnect that you should definitely watch. So, Razi is directed by Meghna Gulzar and stars Alia Bhatt and Vicky Kaushal. I had heard good things about the film and my friends liked it a lot. And I'm gonna express my thoughts on the film. Story: Sehmat Khan, an undercover raw agent, is married into a Pakistan family by her father so that she can get some valuable piece of information about the enemy. Now, this is thrilling because the stakes are enormously high and the film could go a lot of ways. Now, undercover stories are thrilling by nature because the character's cover could be blown and that instantly produces tension and suspense. They have to show themselves a certain way but also do their job without getting caught. And this is exactly what engages us in Sehmat's story, as she gets caught up in a lot of troubles and hardships, how things unfold eventually and how it affects our characters. Now we have interesting characters in this film, and the most nuanced character is obviously Sehmat Khan because we follow her journey and how the whole film is from her perspective. But another reason I found her character interesting is how this mission takes a toll on her mentality and psychologically breaks her because she is forced to take the lives of her family members without getting caught, and that can be extremely painful, and we see that. She nearly kills her husband Iqbal and eventually dies, and she's heartbroken. She has had enough and just wants to leave everything and go home. And that was very human, which made me appreciate the film even more. It was beautiful. Performances: Alia Bhatt, Vicky Kaushal, Jaideep Ahlawat, Soni Razdan, Rajit Kapoor all do a great job. They portray their inner sense of self. Vicky and Alia shine. Vicky's character Iqbal is shown to us as a good man and someone who cares for Sehmat, and his demise is upsetting. And Alia shows the turmoil and torment of Sehmat and is a good actor. Just when she gets the right scripts, she can show her talent. So make sure to comment about your thoughts on this film. I really liked it and love that the Pakistanis aren't caricaturishly evil but are just people doing their job. After watching this film, I am now a huge fan of Juhi Chaturvedi and Shujit Sarkar. Now, if you're wondering, they've worked in other films like Piku and Gulabo Sitabo. Please check out my video on Gulabo Sitabo. Now, October follows Dan, played by Varun Dhawan, and Shuli, played by Banita Sandhu. Both of them work at a hotel. Shuli is nice and sweet and disciplined, whereas Dan is scruffy and constantly complaining. He isn't that likable of a character, and Varun portrays him really well. I'm not kidding. During a party, Shuli slips and falls and goes into a coma, which sets this film into motion. Now, Dan is affected by this and then starts continuously visiting the hospital, which was fascinating. He constantly stays in the hospital and stays beside Shuli, which forms a connection and a bond between the two protagonists. Not a romantic bond, but still a heartfelt and caring bond, which is mostly left unsaid. Now, this is the part of the film where everything becomes really slow. But to be honest, it was some of the best and beautiful parts of the film because it takes its time and meditates on its characters. This isn't necessarily a plot-based narrative. It's a character-based emotional drama that is unpredictable but makes you want to know what can happen with these characters. With Juhi and Varun and Banita managed to pull off really well, they deserve some more appreciation. Now as the film progresses, Dan becomes very likable, and that's because he constantly visits Shuli, bringing positivity within her family and genuinely, passionately caring for Shuli and doesn't ask for anything in return. Such an act of selflessness makes us love him even more because in such a narcissistic world, a man like that stands out from the rest. Everyone gives a great performance. Gitanjali Rao, Banita Sandhu and Varun Dhawan are all exquisite. Banita becomes Shuli and her innocence is portrayed really well, and Varun Dhawan was actually shockingly good. The little nuances and output of the character Varun portrays really well. This shows us that the nepotism actors are capable and can shine when subjected to good screenplays and filmmakers. Now, I love that this film doesn't explore a romantic relationship between Shuli and Dan. Otherwise, that would have been cliche. But does Shuli love Dan? We don't really know, and we don't need to because it doesn't matter. And that's beautiful. Now, spoiler warning, but Shuli dies in the end, and it's heartbreaking because even after all that love Dan gave her, it led to nothing. But I love that this film is named October because of the kind of flowers that fall of which Shuli was fond of, and coincidentally, they both lived a short life as Shuli fell too. Photograph is a very beautiful and tender film that you can watch on Amazon Prime and deserves your love and appreciation. It's really heartwarming. The story. Photograph follows the plot lines of two people, Rafi, who is a photographer working near India Gate with low income, and Miloni, who is a CA topper. Both of them are from different classes and are from totally different sides of life. Rafi, played by Nawazuddin Siddiqui, his grandmother emotionally blackmails him into finding a girl, and so Miloni agrees to pretend to be Rafi's girlfriend. A little unbelievable, but it's better you suspend your disbelief here. The plot is different and mostly simple. The pacing. The pacing is slow and meditates on its characters, which is usually not a bad thing, but it drags a little here, and silence can be powerful. But here, sometimes the silent scenes can get a little boring. The love and connection takes its time and slowly builds it up, but I wish it had taken up pace just a bit quickly. The score. This film has a slow piano theme and background score that brings a certain heart and warmth to the film, which it certainly evokes beautifully. Cinematography. The two cinematographers Ben Cushins and Tom Gillis really capture the essence of the busy streets of Mumbai, the city where people don't really have time for each other and are constantly moving and are in a rush, is captured beautifully by the camera and looks flawless. The performances. The three actors, Nawaz, Sanya and the ever so hilarious Farooq Jaffer, all shine in the film with a cameo from the underrated Vijay Raz. Sanya showcases her talent in this film by showing the silence and shyness of Miloni and how her parents dictate her life. Build some sense of sympathy for her, and her finding comfort with Rafi feels believable and organic, despite their class differences and religious differences, which critiques the toxic mindsets of the general society. And Farooq Jaffer's scenes left me rolling on the floor. She is a true gem and deserves recognition. And now, Nawaz. This shows us that he is a good actor because of his versatility and his ability to portray different shades. He can become a psycho serial killer and also become a shy and timid photographer who loves his family. Absolutely brilliant. Nawaz shows Rafi's shy and innocent nature with absolute perfection and manages to impress you once again with his talent. I like that in the climax, this film ends abruptly, as it never really shows us or tells us what happens with these characters, which leaves us wanting more. It shows us how society is against different classes, religion and color, and holds up the mirror to society itself. Thank you so much for watching. Vilified, shuru kiya ye maine ghar pe, shuru kiya ye maine, shuru kiya ye maine ghar pe, shuru kiya ye maine. शुरू किया ये मैंने घर पे, गुरु बन के आगे है जाना, क्या होगा मुझसे लड़के, ना बदला मेरा इरादा, शुरू किया ये मैंने घर पे।